What was your strategy going into that exchange with Coach Belichick?
Well, I had talked to his consigliere a day or two before and attempting to get a one-on-one, and you know, I knew that was a reach, but I just gave it a shot because I have a pretty good relationship through the years, and I have a lot of respect for Bill and what they do down there. I just you know, because it would be preferable to try to do this in a one-on-one and not in front of everybody. And as I said, if you want to, there's places he doesn't want to go, we don't have to go there. And but anyway, that didn't happen. It was a very respectful decline of the invite. And so I think to that degree, Bill probably knew something was coming. And I understand the beat guys get beaten down there, and just, you know, the reluctance to answer anything. And but this is Dan Patrick. I'm telling you, this is comes up everywhere I go. That's legit.
Yeah.
I talked to Troy Brown last night. You know, 1,000 years in the league, part of this whole Patriot magic ride, and he said the same thing. He said, everywhere I go, that's all people want to ask me. And he said, I know the players. It's part of their lives. So yeah, I think it's a fair game. First day back, you know, opening camp, and here we go. And I knew. To that end, I knew he was going to stonewall, and the fallback is often, we're just talking about now and what's ahead. And so I tried to, well, in that point, what about this year's team?
Yeah.
Is it something you need to address with this year's team? Let's make it about now and do that. And do you care that the fans are not satisfied with this? Does that matter to you? So anyway, again, it's not a party started down there. I understand that. I was really pleased that Bill allowed follow-ups, because that's a lot of follow-up for any session with him. Generally, you get your knees capped off, and that's the end of it. So I thought that was I respected that, and I would appreciate that.
Yeah, I thought the follow-up, that's where it turned a little bit and at least made him pause, because if you're a current Patriot player, I would still want to know, like, what did he do? Yeah. That cost us perhaps a Super Bowl. We had a bad secondary. We made it even worse. Like, there's no explanation. Like, this is pretty amazing that it's been this quiet, that it, you know, neither side has said much about this.
Yeah, it's a tough one. I mean, you know, this is a guy who obviously he won the Super Bowl in the Seattle game 3 years ago, and with a great play at the end, and he was an all-pro cornerback, and he played in 98% of the snaps this year. He didn't come off the field against Jacksonville 2 weeks earlier, and now he's not playing. And it was just, and you know, they can't get the Eagles off the field. They lose a game, which they don't punt. They put together 600 yards of offense. The quarterback throws for 505, and they still lose because, you know, Batamosi's out there arm tackling in the second half. Malcolm Butler, even when he's not playing his best game, he tackles. And it was just, it was curious, and it didn't look like they were putting their best foot forward. And, you know, all these things came out early on, you know, weed and concerts and curfews and illnesses and, you know, interfering with the elections and just, you know, they tried everything. And Butler said none of that stuff's true. And he was backed up by teammates on social media, including Gronkowski, Hightower, and Brady.
What's it like going toe-to-toe when everybody is there watching the exchange with you and Belichick?
Well, it's like Belichick. You got to be prepared, and you know, I've learned that from Bill and Red Auerbach and all my journalistic forefathers. You know, just be prepared, because you kind of, all these years, you sort of know he's not going to love this. But I tried to appeal to him as a sports fan. You're a fan. I know he loves baseball and he goes to Celtic games and he gets it. You know, he's wondering about LeBron James. So just as that, let's just try to just go that route. And I tried to appeal like, I'm doing my job, you know. That was not an accidental, you know, notion that I was tucking in there. That's what I'm doing. And he professes, do your job. So that's what I'm doing. And I thought he was extremely, for something he hates to talk about and doesn't want to go to, I thought he was extremely polite and professional about it.
Have you asked Brady about what he thinks of not knowing?
You know, I have not. I think there's some, you know, there's all those, you know, it's like, reading hieroglyphics and hints and stuff. There's been some stuff in Tom versus Time, and maybe with the Jim Gray interview where he, I think it once, Troy told me that is Tom at one point says that Malcolm's talking to him on the sideline, and Tom's like, wait a minute, why aren't you in the game? You know, and he's, and I think that, you know, that they were like, this, are we really having our best team out here? And especially when you can't get those guys off the field. Dan, they didn't punt and they lost the Super Bowl. It's impossible.
For more Dan Patrick Show, tune to Audience Channel 239 on DirecTV or download the Dan Patrick Show app.